walk in the room and you shine like diamonds. Boy, I can feel your vibe. Boy, I can feel your fire. Plenty in the room, but you won't shine them. Baby, you just my type. Baby, you what I like. Tell me, can I be the one you give them shivers? Boy, you like it when I see her. Love me like firelight. Love me like promise that I never make you cry like river. Tell me when and how to live her. Love me like firelight. Better with passing time. You can make all the stars in the sky start falling. And never be by your side till the angels call it. But even when I'm not around, boy right there, boy right there. Always on call away. When call away. When call away. Always on call away. When call away. When call away. Always on call.
Hi guys, so this is an oka from my mum.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning. Oh, it's an afternoon.
Welcome to
Morena, Talo for Love.
Welcome to Becca
Yusef's YouTube channel. Look, you can see here, this is my oka. There's
you're
two
so
other
sad.
Containers
it's
there.
Not
even
recording, bro.
Oh, sad.
No, I'm joking.
It is. It is recording.
And anyway, it's Tōnai time, and Tōnai is when everyone gets together on a Sunday and has lunch with the family. So I'm just waiting for my mum to like get the Povi Masima, or Daniel's Povi Masima, and you can come and check out the table here. It's nearly ready to go.
Why are you
putting
that on the table?
Huh?
Oh, no, this is like a one serving. This is not all.
Yeah. Before you come with the color of a lot,
what do we have here?
Bobby Masuma,
Bobby Masuma,
block up the arteries.
Bobby Masuma,
yes, and this is a Fai Aileen.
Fai
Aileen.
Oh,
that's
it.
That's a fire yelling if I leave. See that? Ooh. Yeah, it's my favorite.
Yeah. Wow. That was from our neighbor's
yeah.
Next door.
From our neighbor. So nice.
Good morning. So it is a Sunday. So we don't go to church. So we are starting our day with a family gourmet before we head out for the day. So usually it's just my mother and father-in-law that live here with my sister-in-law. So the house is not really catered to this many people. So we are making do with the space that we have.
to go back and forth in the field. They took out my dollar and forth and forth for a while. And I took my container.
So we have Fai Aelengi, we have fish, we have Galokao, we have Bobby Masima with Tapisi, we have Sapasui, we have Fali Fokalo, we have Uno, we also have Duau and more Galokao.
What is that for eating?
Yeah.
Look over there. He's sitting by himself.
Oh, I thought that's the kids eating first. What kind of kid is this?
I'm my mom's kid.
He's asking for a bag.
Oh, where was it?
What
do you have? I love you.
This mum, tell mum to come and eat.
Mum, come
Let's
eat.
Let's eat. Come eat, mum.
Let's have my morning coffee.
Come and eat out here.
Hey, kele no timale. Una sulule ye ai.
Oh.
You like it?
Oh, sorry.
Alright, this is next level.
No, yeah. It's really just
dinner. It's a different way. That's nice, this is Fai Aelengi.
That's a spoon for the fish.
It's beautiful.
There's fish
in
there.
Hmm?
What is it?
Oh my. That's the ish. That's hit the spot with that one.
It's nice, eh? Did you see?
Here's another one then. Yeah. Have everybody have a picture.
They are no complaining. Not that hungry. How's the Povi Masima?
Mm-hmm.
Can you feel it clogging up the artery straight away?
I love it.
There's heaps of food, boys.
Sorry, I just got I got the ulu. I love ulu. Sorry, sapasui, Povi Masima, cabbage.
Yes, I usually don't buy it.
So you don't worry.
I do.
You should treat us all equally. And Becca Asian name had a drink too. I heard her coughing this morning.
Oh,
yeah, she's like that. I'm trying to hide it. What's this recording? Hi guys, we're here on the table, on the blue table. We're here with some parents. Is it recording?
Yeah.
We're here with, Sartala. It's just Sartala.
Sartala.
It's not Sartala, it's Sartala. Sartala. And Severe. So Sartala, Severe. Oh, amazing. Chilu Mangaku. So this is going on, bro.
Togetherness, kakwai. How is it seeing your grandkids, your kids and your grandkids?
Can
you speak up to the mic a bit more?
Maa, kere kako mafukama, you know, with your kids, your wives, same as Lua and her husband, and all your wife. Friend kids.
Yeah.
Lua's wife.
It's very, 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 very nice, you know. It's, for me, it's nice when you're here. Mm. I'm start counting the day you're going to leave, you know.
What did I just say before? Yeah. Shouldn't count the days, you should make the days count.
Okay, Angalu. That's all, but it was really nice having you kids, and thank you for buying those two dryers, brand new, for the laundromat. We really appreciate that. Yeah.
You're welcome. How about you, man? Yeah. The camera's over there. I think your parents are about to cry. Mm. Oh, I was just joking.
I think as I get older, I get emotional. I'm trying to hide it all around. But, I think this is once in a lifetime. Once in a lifetime that we can do this. And I really appreciate you, because we both do, Dad. Appreciate you kids for being here. I think we're blessed with everything that you've done for me, for us. It's my cup is full.
Okay, so we went for a Sunday drive. And we're about an hour out from home. Brayden. And our tyre went flat on Brayden. Us on Why our rental. So I don't know if we're going to be stranded, but yep, that's about how I'm feeling at the moment.
Ma, maybe turn the car off, please.
Yep. Is gone.
Lua!
Can you turn the car off?
You know what? It's good for the memories. That time we broke down in Kuasavati.
Yeah.
We landed with cows. And the tire was so burnt we could have probably died if we had gone a bit further.
Always thought.
You're doing a good job. Jacob,
go
look for it.
Leave you broke down, guys.
Go look for a rock. That's what you can do.
Yeah.
I think this rock.
Jacob, come away over this side.
But the problem is,
that's a solid one.
Jenny is doing so good. Look at this. That is how you hold the van up. Look at that. Yes. I'm not sure about if this is doing anything. Are you trying to stop traffic or?
Let it go now.
Let it go?
I'm just stressing me out because it just falls on me. I'm going to sue.
Who are you going to sue? We're not saying anything.
I'm going to sue someone.
Good morning. It is Monday. It is 9:30. And myself and my niece Summer, so we went to go have breakfast, but there was no milk. So we decided to go on a walk and we've ended up at RTV. So we're having burger and fries for breakfast. No one knows we're here, but once they watch this on YouTube, then they'll know where we went. How's your breakfast? I would feel guilty, but I'm so hungry.
The minute they walk past.
So we have our food now. So we both got the cheese beef burger combo. So it's a large combo. So this is the fries, this is the burger, and get some sauce as well. And it was about, I think it was 19 tala per meal, so I paid 38 tala
for our breakfast this morning.
Hey guys, so what have we done today so far? So me and Summer had breakfast at RTV, then we went back home and we cleaned up the laundromat for my father-in-law. So we did a little bit of work in there, and it looks really good now. After the cleaning, we went out to lunch. We went to DMC with the family and we couldn't help ourselves. So we are back at Apu'a'au Waterfall to spend the day. So when we came last time, Noor didn't get to come with her husband because she wasn't feeling well. So this is her first time, but everyone else is second time. So we're all back here again. So we'll probably be here till they close today, because we've got a late start to our day. So I think it's going on to 2:30 now, and they close at 5. Okay, time for a swim.
His family are leaving Savai'i today, and that's going to be the last time that we see them on this trip. So they are the second lot to leave.
Well, they're not actually leaving the country, they're just leaving Savai'i, but they'll be here till next Saturday, but they'll be staying with Evelyn's family. So yeah, time to say goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh,
goodbye,
Malachi. Oh,
see you, Brick. Yeah,
OG. Where are my shoes? Enjoy the rest of your trip. Yeah, we'll see you guys soon anyway. That's all good. Thank you guys too. Love you.
For the kids, mate.
Love you, Libby. Love you, kids.
I don't love you.
What's Brownie? Can Brownie get to the front of the car?
He's Brownie.
I mean, not Brownie. Where's that Brownie?
No, Fish is here. It's not bad, though.
Fish, come to the front of the car. All right.
No!
Brownie.
Come here.
Bye.
Come here.
Yes. Have fun on your working visa. Now there's more room in the house.
I said, thank goodness, now there's more room in the house.
Sad guy.
Son, just think about your tattoo tomorrow.
So it's our last night in Savaii. So Lou and his family left this morning. I didn't vlog today. We're just spending time with the family. But we went out and we got Daniel's dad a new table and washing powder and fabric softener for the laundromat, just to add some finishing touches before we leave and just to help him out with his business. So at the moment everyone is just packing, getting ready for our ferry tomorrow. We're getting the first ferry to Upolu tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock. Then tomorrow we have planned, we'll probably just go for breakfast when we get in. Then Liev has a tattoo appointment at 9 o'clock, so he's getting his first tattoo, and he's gonna get an armband. So he wants to get the same armband as what his dad has, but hopefully the tattoo artist can add a modern twist to it, because Dan got it when he was 14 years old, so it's very old school. So just see what everyone is up to. So Dan's just packing here. Ella, what are you doing? Are you having brownies already?
Yeah, I'm cutting it for everyone.
So next door, Daniel's dad's cousin lives there, and she's a baker, so she's made us some brownies. She also made us a pineapple pie for dessert tonight. Saz packing here.
Is that mum's?
No. So Nazi and Tima, they're also packing because they're gonna spend our last night with us in Apia. So we just got to the laundromat. I'll just show you the table and stuff we got. So this is what it's looking like. So we got him a new table here, and these are all the fabric softeners we got. And all of his laundry powders, so that should last him for ages. So we did do some work in here yesterday. So we did some cleaning up, fixed the ceiling. It's all clean now. How does it feel to be leaving Savaii? This is your last night in Savaii.
It's all good.
All good?
It's been a good trip.
So today, Daniel went with the kids and Daniel's dad, and the kids got to meet their great-grandfather for the first time. So that was cool. So we got some photos of that. So that was like four generations that they had there today. So
yeah, that was good. So there's always a backstory to everything. I'm not gonna get into it, but it was good to see him again. So it was 5 years ago, it was the last time that Becca and I seen him, and before that was years. So to talk about my grandfather to our kids, I enjoyed that we got to witness our kids' visit, as well as our great aunties, so Childe, Auntie Faikeke and Auntie Sifanga, just beautiful people, eh? So that they all live here and stuff. So this is a story for another time as well, you know, just the family tree. I've just been trying to learn as well as much as I can from my dad over the last few days, just trying to get as much as I can out of him, you know, because time is precious. So it's been good. It was good.
Thank you.
Good morning. It is 6:45 and we have just parked onto the ferry. So we are leaving Sava'i today. It is our last day here. And heading back to Upolu because we fly out tomorrow. So we've decided just to sit in the van for the ride instead of going upstairs. Because it's the first ferry, so the weather is nice and cool this morning. So yeah, so we'll see you when we arrive in Upolu. Good morning, Lotima.
Good morning, guys. So, we're leaving Sava'i. We're on the Lady Samoa III, the big ferry. And we're on our way to Muni Fumua because this time tomorrow, you guys will be at the airport. We'll be saying goodbye. And I'll probably be crying.
Any words, honey? Okay, so we're at the tattoo place and change of plans. I'm getting tattooed first, which was a last minute decision. So I'm going to get tattooed first so my son can see if he can handle getting a tattoo or not. So he's getting second thoughts.
So just here with Liev, Lincoln, Benka. Kama's lucky to get an appointment for his Kaulima. So see how it goes. He's committed. Once he feels the needle, it's a different story. Also, got something new to show us there?
got Dan here for some support. So Liev's getting what his dad's got. He's gonna get a more modern looking one, but he wanted what his dad has. So he can be 20 with his dad.
How do you feel? Safety. So, just finished Leo's tat. That is Craig's tattoo shop and a barber shop as well. Awesome experience, friendly. No. Lincoln's right, but it still looks good. That's what happens when you talk too much.
It's not a shame.
Tiki, how do you feel? Like, what was your initial thought when you first felt the needle?
It hurt.
Yeah? Yeah? Come here. Hello, boys. Yeah, good experience though. It's really nice. He done an awesome job, man. That really looks cool. It stands out so much. And darling, did I record your...
Yeah, you already recorded it.
Pain?
So this part of the finger, I couldn't believe how sore it was just for this part here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was the worst. And just near the bone wasn't so bad, but this... So I'm glad I didn't get all of the fingers done.
Yeah. No, well done. And myself, the eighth update. And myself, I got a sibling's tat. By the way, bro. So, I'll explain the story, but myself and my siblings all got the.
Why don't you explain it now?
No, because we're gonna go. I'm for your eight too. We gotta go Kapwai Alice.
So it's 450, but the whole band was meant to be 650.
Oh wow.
Awesome.
Yours?
380.
Nice.
Is that cheap for tattoo?
They still charge the same as a full thing, but if I got the full thing, it's just all lines, but it's all detailed then.
Yeah. Hello. Alright, I think I need a... Just off to Macca's for a quick bite. Then we'll figure out the rest of the day then.
So my niece Ella is just getting her thigh band done at the moment. So we're here at Manamea Studio. So she looks like she's in quite a bit of pain. So we're all here to support her and to let her know that she can do it. Can't wait to see when it's done. It's looking so good. All right, so since we're here at the studio, I'm gonna show you some of this guy's artwork, because I just had a quick look and it's amazing. This with the candle of Erlingi. Wow. Beautiful it is. I love this one. So it looks like they also do like the 21st keys, the keys that you get for your 21st birthday. So we're here now at Tal Mesina and we are just checking in. Hi guys, so we've just checked into Tal Mesina and what an experience at check-in. So they gave us Lay's and then they gave us a welcome drink and I feel so special. I feel like I'm famous or something. So I'm pretty sure Daniel was saying the Fiji rugby team is staying here.
I think I just made it up.
Okay, so we're just going to our villa now and we are going to meet Tima there. So the grounds from my view, beautiful, so nice. So perfect way to spend our last night in Samoa. Okay, so we're just about to walk into our villa. We are in villa number 9. So this is just outside our balcony. So there's just the entrance there to swim into the beach. So we're gonna go for a walk and see where the swimming pool is. But the view is so beautiful. Look at that. And just got the kids. So they've just hooked onto the Wi-Fi and have not moved from these seats. He's coming. We're going to go have a look at the pool. You just want to stay. We'll be back, guys.
Oh, I have no idea what I'm doing.
All right, let's go.
First, drink a diversion.
You want a card?
Yeah, I've got the card.
I'm trying to be the average.
So this is just outside the room. We've just parked our rental in front. So the beach goes all the way around on that side. You've got a kids playground as well. I think this is like an outdoor gym area. So this is the bar area, which is just near the entrance. So this is where you check in. Then you have like a Janet's store in the corner that's got all souvenirs and stuff. So the bar area, and we're just walking out to the pool. So it's a big pool area. So this must be the restaurant. Do you want to walk around then go down? So beautiful, swimming in the pool.
looking over into the ocean. So they have kayaks and snorkeling gear that you can use for free if you're staying here. So you can swim on this part of the beach as well. I think over there is where like sometimes people have like their wedding ceremonies and stuff. You want to walk on that side? Okay, so we're back from our walk. And we got some drinks delivered to our room. So this is the strawberry daiquiri fish bowl. It's huge. I am not gonna finish that. And Daniel just got a bucket of towels. And we're just about to get some drone footage from where our room is. Cheers, big ears. So we're having Georgie's pizza for dinner tonight. So Nautima bought our dinner for tonight. So that's the pepperoni. So if you haven't heard of Georgie's Pizza, apparently it's like the most popular pizza place in Samoa. And I must say, they're pretty good. So that's the pepperoni. And this is the Hawaiian. I love the base, it's so good. We've got Dan outside with Nutty. Oh, go manga, you lost
it. Is it on the right side?
Yeah.
Oh, the single side?
That's the other side. That's Mama Nutty.
You're supposed to make that for me. Father, I'm not a video, so. Sorry.
So our brother ended up coming with his family to visit us. That's how missing him. So we already said goodbye, now we have to say goodbye again.
Remember we mentioned the other day?
Like yesterday,
come on, but I'm saying we mentioned the other day.
Beck is taller than you. What are you talking about?
Yeah, you had to look up.
Hey,
no.
But they might be the same height, actually.
He's not counting. He's only 90 years old.
I feel like I'd have to get a little bit thick because my...
You shrink as you get older.
I'm like that.
I'm taller than
you. Well, should have been taller than you.
But I want to know like how far I'll
we'll see you guys tomorrow.
All right. So Summer's thinking of getting a thigh tattoo like Emma.
I want it a bit further up.
I think it'll be nice.
Well,
there.
Oh,
crap. Yeah, so
not too low.
You're going to
get it
too soon.
Come on.
Bye.
Oh,
it's
a
key. I can go out.
Not
at
the.
We'll go out. She's going to go out. We'll go out and say bye.
Is it the closest room or what?
She left the new menus on there. I've only got room 4. Where is she? I only got room 4. See you then.
So we pretty much came to do our shopping.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for coming now.
But I
think it's
got old.
Yeah, I agree.
Hey, Jacob. Make you buy here somewhere.
I know.
See you in the morning. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Sit down, Summer.
Tell her to get off the edge.
Sit down. Okay. Listen. I never listen.
Morning, guys. So it is almost 3:30. So we're up early. So I've just checked out. And we're waiting for Tima to pick us up because we're leaving today, so she'll be taking us to the airport. So I just wanted to say, like, our stay here at Tel Messina was so good. I highly recommend the service, everything was just amazing just from the get-go, so all the way to check out. So I've just gone to check out and they made us 4 takeaway breakfast packs, which are just on the suitcase over there. So in the breakfast packs, you get a toasty, I think it's like a ham and cheese toasty, a Danish, a croissant, a donut, a piece of fruit. There was something else, I can't remember. So I thought that was pretty good because we actually miss out on the breakfast because it doesn't start till 6:30. What else? Yeah, so just waiting for Tima. Daniel and Naughty have gone walkabouts. So we'll see you guys at the airport.
Thank you. Okay, we should have to.
Bye, guys. Have a safe trip. Don't forget to follow me on my TikTok again. Jesus.
Final. All right. Love you too.
Safe trip, okay?
We'll see you soon.
Where's
Bye, Mom. Thank you for everything. We'll miss you. We'll be back soon.
Okay, see you soon.
Yeah, okay. Send our love to Emma as well.
Please send my love to your mom.
I will. Bye, life of a FIFA wife. Love you too. Thank you. We'll see you soon.
Yeah.
Bye, Noah. Love you. Gonna miss your hugs. We'll see you soon, eh? Bye, Jacob. Oh, I love you. Miss you.
Have a safe flight.
We will. Thank you.
You're sad.
Why?
Bye, Summer. Love you. It was so good seeing you too. Send our love to Elliot.
Saving the best for last.
Okay, so we finally boarded our flight. Said bye to all our family, which was hard. Once we got through the gate thing, I think it hit me and I got a bit emotional. We had time to do a bit of shopping up in the duty free. So we've got everyone. We've got Lua, Ili, and we have Sina. Sina's on our flight. So our friend Sina's coming back home with us. On our way to Brisbane, then Brisbane to Perth. So we will see you in Brisbane. Hi guys, so we are at Brisbane Airport.
So when we landed, we were at the international terminal to catch the bus to the domestic terminal to get our flight to Perth. So we are now here. We've just had something to eat before our flight. So we had Carl's Jr. So we don't have Carl's Jr. in WA. So everyone enjoyed it. How was the flight? So the flight from Samoa to Brisbane was 6 hours. And it was okay, but there was this lady on the flight and she was just so rude. So she kept standing in the aisle, and every time people were trying to go to the toilet, she wouldn't move. So yeah, she was standing here in the middle. So people were like, it almost looked like they were had to shove her to get through. So it was so annoying because she was in like two rows ahead of us, so I could see everything. So even when she was walking up and down the aisle, she kept like shoving me, like she kept bumping into me, but it wasn't like my arms were like hanging out. It was like she was doing it on purpose. So she was really pissing me off. So I had to like take a deep breath, because I didn't want to be like those Karens that you see how they lose their shit on the planes. I didn't want that. I didn't want people recording me. So yeah, so I just had to hold that in. But if she didn't have a baby, I think I might have said something, but she had a baby on the flight. So, but I just thought she was so rude. She was so disrespectful with what she was doing. Like, she wasn't even letting like the air hostess like get through to like take coffees and stuff, you know, for the other people on the flight. So that was annoying. Other than that, it was okay. We're all tired. So we've been up since like 3 o'clock this morning. So now we are waiting for a flight that departs at 12:20, which would be in about 40 minutes or so. So Dan, Dua and Saeedi have just gone out for a smoke and Singa as well. So I'm just here with the kids. So everyone's just charging up all their electronics at the power stations here, getting ready for the next flight. So we're all missing our family back in Samoa. Just, it feels a bit weird trying to adjust back, being back into Australia. So it's a bit weird. Just like, I don't know, just all the luxuries we have here. So yeah, it's gonna take some getting used to. So once we get into Perth, we're there for 3 days. We have an Airbnb before we drive back to Kalgoorlie. So we're all staying at the Airbnb. We thought we'd just stay there for a couple of days just to relax, just, you know, from our holiday before our 6 hour drive back home. Yeah, I think that's about it. So our next flight is to Perth, so we'll see you guys in Perth. Do you miss your mum and dad? What a liar. He was crying on the plane. He was crying when we walked through the gate, actually.
How are we for takeoff?
We haven't even taken off. And this guy's already asleep. Good morning, it is Friday morning. So we are at our Airbnb. So we checked in yesterday. I thought we'd get in earlier because our flight got in around 4:30, but we didn't get into the Airbnb until, what time was it? 6:30 last night. And we were all so tired, just being up from 3 in the morning. So Laura did say she was on a call with her mum this morning and she's still crying. So I'll maybe just stay away from the phone calls for a couple of days. Yeah. So I'll just show you around the house and what the kids are doing. Liev and Malachi just on the piano. Braden's having breakfast. Mm-hmm.
smoker's corner. It's got our pool area. This is the alfresco. Okay, so I'll show you the kids' rooms. So this is the dining area. Then you got the living area. This is the kitchen. So this house is so cool. They have like all these buttons. So this is what the buttons are for, and they switch on for different areas, which is so cool. All right, so this is Brayden and Malachi's room. This is the bathroom. So sink, massive bathtub. Bathtub with a view. So it's a deep soaking tub. Got your shower. This is Lincoln and Liev's room. So this one has two single beds. He's still in bed. And they also have a TV. So it's a 5-bedroom home. So I think Ella might still be sleeping. Oh no, she's straightening her hair. First day back in Samoa and she's straightening her hair. And this is Ella's room. All right, so now I'll show you one of the master bedrooms. So there's two master bedrooms in this house. This is like a little study nook as well. So this is Lou and Illy's room. So they also have a wardrobe. So you step down into it. Got a little chair there in the corner. So nice, hey? And this is my room, mine and Daniel's room. So this is like it's like its own living quarters. So you've got your own toilet, shower. Sorry, my stuff is everywhere. But you have a table and it's got like a little kitchen area and a washing machine and dryer. So just switch the lights on. Yeah. So that is in the room. Sorry, this is the front gate to get inside. So our cars are just parked outside. But check out this massive chess board game. So the kids are gonna love using this today. And that is the front yard. So at the moment, everyone is just relaxing. Everyone's had a good night's sleep, which was very muchly needed. So I didn't get to vlog yesterday once we got into Perth. My brains were just not functioning right by the time we got in. So our second flight from Brisbane to Perth, it was the worst flight ever. So it was only like, I think it was just over 5 hours, but the flight felt like it was 10 hours. So I was getting really frustrated in there, restless. What else? Turbulence was really bad, takeoff and landing. So so once we got in yesterday, everyone just wanted to relax. So we had Sina with us last night, but she left this morning. She Ubered it to the airport. I think she missed her family so much that she couldn't wait to go back home, so she left this morning instead of leaving on Sunday. So we check out on Sunday and today is Friday. So we've got Dan here who is just doing our washing.
Morning, guys.
Back to reality. So we're just going to do a couple loads of washing before we head out for the day. We'll discuss with everyone what we're going to do. What else? What do you think we'll have for lunch or dinner tonight?
Lunch will be whatever. We can organize something for dinner.
Yeah. So lunch, we could probably just go to a food court or something. And then dinner, we'll just have something at home.
Yeah.
So we can just chill.
Yeah.
That sounds good to me because I do not want to be driving and we don't need to be spending more money. So yeah, we are missing We're missing everyone so much. Daniel's mom, dad, sister Nautima, brother Angelo, and his family. It really was. It was the best trip. It is the best holiday that I have ever been on. So, beats all our family holidays and everything. Back in the day when I used to go to Samoa, so like my mum's family, like they live Gua, like in Lefanga. So we never really got to go out and do like sightseeing things. I don't know, but it's not something like my mum's family like did for us when we used to travel there on holiday. We would just stay in Gua the whole time that we were in Samoa. And so when I think back on holidays in Samoa, that is what I remember, is just staying in my mum's village or staying with my dad's family, which is in Kalimakau, so like in Abia. So, and also when we were at my dad's family, we would also just stay at the house. We never went sightseeing. So this trip, we did a lot of sightseeing. We did a lot of touristy things and got to experience so much. So I think we probably ticked off most of the list of like all the places that we wanted to go to. So every day, if we didn't go out and see something, we were swimming. So every day was busy. The kids enjoyed it. So doing all of that and also being able to experience it with all the family as well together. It was really good. It was an awesome trip. We'll always remember it. And also getting to spend time on both islands as well. So in Upolu as well as Savai'i. So I've only been to Savai'i once before, back in 2018. And even that time then, we only stayed at Daniel's parents' place. So this trip, we actually got to go around. We didn't get to go around the whole island, but we probably did half of the island. But still, we probably did all the main attractions in the time that we were there. Okay, so we've just arrived at Karanyup Waters, or Karanyup Shopping Centre. So first up this morning, the boys went to go get a body massage. Just for a quick pick-me-up before we spend our day at the shopping centres. I went and got my eyebrows threaded and my upper lip and my chin, so I'm feeling fresh. But I just realised, watching back my other videos, how trash my lashes are looking. So they've lasted 3 weeks in Samoa. But look at that. I so need a refill. But anyways, tomatoes have arrived. And Dan was just at the info screen trying to see where all the food courts are. So we're trying to find somewhere for lunch. Alright, so we finally found a food court. Took forever to find where all the food places were, but we got there. So this shopping center is massive. Look at this. How beautiful. Okay. So we're just trying to find, we went past heaps of places that just had like cafes and stuff, but we wanted somewhere that had more variety, so not everyone wants to eat the same thing. So we are here. So this will do for now. So we are on level one, which all the designer shops are at. So no shopping on level one today. What'd you get, Liev? So Liev got the HSP box with garlic sauce and chili sauce. How's it? Yeah, Lincoln got a burrito. How's the burrito? Do you regret getting that? Because I heard you arguing you want some of that.
I'll have anything.
What'd you get, honey?
Chicken.
How's it? Good? What is this?
Fish.
Wow. This guy's gonna be sweating soon. So I just got a poke bowl. I got some beef bao buns. And I also got a lychee fruit tea with tropical jelly. So I think this might be Illy's food, some Chinese. What'd you get, Brayden? Fish and chips. And Ella, what did you get? She got a kebab. Show your nails. So Ella got her nails done.
Oh, they're a bit messy.
It looks so good. Okay, let's see how this food. I love the seaweed. So I got some seaweed in my food. And I love pickled ginger. Got pickled ginger.
Finish your lunch. Now the favorite part of the shopi is waiting. Waiting for the shopping people. So hard job. But when I'm shopping for myself, I love it. I've been shopping all day. But when you shop for other people, it's too much effort. You know what I'm saying?
Alright, I'll just place this in. Alright, which here are we doing? I'll just give it a clean.
Don't post it.
I won't post it.
Are you posting?
I'm not.
Promise for
you. Just gonna mark it and then I'll show you in the mirror and we can move it around if you want to. Have you had it done before? Maybe look at that. Let me know if you want it moved at all.
I have no idea, so.
Usually that would be like general sort of spot.
Oh, yeah.
Cool. And we're doing silver diamonds, hey?
Yes, please.
Lined up for us. Ready? 1, 2, 3. And done.
Thank you.
That's all right. I'll show you in the mirror.
Thank you.
That's okay. Well done. Show me your ear piercing. Lee just got his ear pierced. It's looking pretty red there, mate.
Yeah, because
it freaking hurt. It freaking hurt. So Lincoln didn't want to get a tattoo, but he got his ears pierced. So who's now? Brayden and
Malachi.
Any piercings today?
Maybe just my
Okay, next please. How's it healing?
Show it.
Mum's doing the camera.
I'm saying, how is it healing? It's been good.
It's not finished. Stop touching
me. Ooh, this guy. You doing selfie? Show me Kai. So Kai just got his as well. And Brayden got his other ear pierced.
Is it red?
It's blue for blue cup one.
I think someone is missing. Samoa. What are you doing, honey? Do you miss Samoa? You have to go look at Samoa.
No, I
was
going to show the kids where Samoa.
Okay, so we just got home from shopping not long ago. I did not think we would be there the whole day, but we were actually there till they were closing. So we did heaps of shopping, just bought stuff for the kids, and we got some stuff for dinner tonight. So we are just going to have a sausage sizzle at home, in our Airbnb. Just something easy because we're still on holiday and I don't want to be standing here cooking while I'm still on holiday. So the boys are going to cook our sausages. So we got our sausages. So just got our fries ready to put in the oven. Cut our onions as well. Oh, and I've got to show this. So what we got here. How cool is this sign? So the owners did that for us when we got here for the Airbnb. So just a little welcome pack from the owners. What are you doing over here? Are you getting your drink ready?
Yes.
You need to be doing the barbecue, not drinking right now. We've got Saz in the back getting the Barbie ready. So boys got the barbecue. I don't know what the girls are doing. So we thought we wouldn't eat out for dinner, not only because we don't want to cook, but to also just so we can chill and enjoy the Airbnb. Are you looking for something? The pots are down here. Over there. All right, so the Barbie, got the Barbie going. Sausages are sizzling, alright? This guy's just smiling because you've got this fella over here. Nowhere. What you playing, Liev? Good morning. It's Sunday morning, and we are checking out of the Airbnb today. So I didn't even get to vlog yesterday. So we ended up spending another day at a shopping center and just took the kids out to Holy Moly, just to get them to do something for the day, because we've just been relaxing at the Airbnb. So we are driving back to Kalgoorlie today, so it's a 6-hour drive. So we're just doing some last minute cleaning in the Airbnb so they can leave me a good review. So we'll probably just head out for breakfast this morning with the kids and hopefully make our way to Kalgoorlie and we don't stop anywhere else for more shopping. But we'll see, because then you're always, I don't know, out of the blue. Oh, I need something. I need this. I need that. So hopefully none of that happens. All right. So we'll see you guys on the road. Are you going to miss the Airbnb?
Yes,
I will. Alright, so we'll just clean.
Yeah, you know, it's been fun. But really good.
I feel like I haven't really been able to enjoy it because I'm so tired.
I know, you have been. So the weather's been so cold, we didn't even get to enjoy the pool outside.
Just split the crepes. And tell you what's up.
Okay, looks like everyone is all packed and ready to go. I'm not sure where we're having breakfast yet. I don't know if we're going to Costco before we go back. I know that's not in the plans, but
there's no way.
They have cheap pizza there.
There's no way.
Okay, so we're at this little cafe for breakfast called Last Crumb Co. in Bassendean in Perth. So their food's actually so good. Still got pies. I got a cinnamon scroll as well. I got a cake. I got a cookie. I got a Danish. I got everything. You know, can't forget the Wadi sauce.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, so we have arrived in Kalabaran. So that's 2 hours down, and we have 4 hours to go till we get back home. So we're just having a stop off.
Hey guys! Oh my god. I'm lulli ass, man.
Black.
Yeah, so, he's been kapwaing the lady while she's been driving, so now we just.
Whatever, he slept the whole way. Now he just and changed. These kids, they slept the whole way too.
How are they sleeping?
Like this.
I wake up and there was Fawu on the seatbelt.
So I've lost 0 kilos since we've been on holiday. Have we put on any weight? If I have put on weight, it's because of this tan's made me a bit heavier. But
so I've put on, and I think I've put on heaps of weight. I can tell because this t-shirt, when I used to wear this t-shirt before Samoa, was nice and loose. Now it's a bit fussy, so.
So probably maybe just one more stop till we get back. Awesome. So yeah, time to hit the road.
Where's the key?
Southern Cross now, getting closer to Kalgoorlie because it's getting more brown. No grass at all. So everyone's just having another break. Pass this to Noah.
to Kalgoorlie. How does it feel to be home?
Feel like I'm gonna come here. Feel I'm gonna have a couple of drinks tonight and have a bit of a cry.
You happy to be home?
Where's your home, son?
Samoa.
Lincoln? Australia? This is Lincoln's home, guys. No, it's good to be back. I get into a, back into a routine. But, you know, very sad at the same time. Driving in, you come to the realization that the holiday is over.
Let's see if the tall mutters pull up. They were behind us the whole way. So we are now going our own ways.
Maloa Fauli.
Maloa Fauli.
We're home, guys.
We'll see you tonight. Yeah. Bye.
Where they go?
They're going home.
This way is quicker for us.
About that time they stand up for